Good, good. So when y'all go camping or hiking, how many of you carry a backpack?
And then they would actually sneak and stay in the woods and watch you.
What do you carry? Where are you from? You're not from South Georgia?
No.
So that's it, right? What else do you carry? Anybody carry anything else other than food and water? What you carry?
Yeah, this is one of my kids. I actually
should
try to
show them. What was the last thing? Again, learning a lot from kids. So, who carries the bag? Who carries the backpack? All right. So, what happens if something happens to the bag? What do you do? Seriously though, I mean, think about it. We had a lady this morning. She depended on her husband to carry a backpack. That was her thing. And unfortunately, that's what my wife did. Is she depends on me to carry the backpack. So I make her start carrying a few things in her own. You know, she doesn't believe that she can start a fire except for me. Right? It's always me or one of my kids. And so I made her start carrying a lighter in her pocket. Right? Start a fire just in case. And all of my family knows how to start a fire. But it goes beyond that, right? Is if something were to happen, God forbid, I go off on a trail, I fall down a hill, and I'm, you know, where I can't be reached, we'll just go that route. Then she has to be able to move on and carry on without me. And so there's a couple of things that we look at in carrying gear, such as carrying a tarp or a blanket and making a shelter out of it. When we're in the woods. So one way to look at it is what we call a 5-minute shelter.
This concept comes down to
building what's called a lean-to, which many of you are familiar with, right? It leans to this size. We take and build it that way. We want to make sure that we're able to use it to its fullest extent. But what happens again if you lose that backpack? I lose the tarp. I don't have the tarp. I don't have the blanket. Then what? So then we take this concept of the fact that we know what a lean-to looks like, and we change it up. And we say, now beyond the tarp,
you're some god to everybody.
We take this lean-to. And the side of it goes this way, this route. We see the side of it goes this route, and we can do the same thing with sticks. Right? So you can take and do sticks up against another stick and lay it in that side, right? So it forms the same purpose. Well, take it one step further, right? If you take it one step further, it says that instead of doing it this way, we're going to take and do what's called a plow point. And that plow point, starts looking at it from this perspective. And if we take this plow point, you can do it in within a 5-minute period of time. You can use wooden stakes, not just plastic ones. And you can use a stick to hammer them in. But when we start looking at a plow point as an example,
he wakes up.
We start realizing, hey, if we didn't have a tarp, what happens, right? So we can take a stick and lay it down and do the same thing with branches. Right? We're still looking at it from a different perspective and having it to where it's tight and taut and still get up in there. Well, the same concept applies to fire. So we look at the shelter and see it one way and being able to do it in different fashions, in different ways. But when we look at fire, again, I carry a lighter, but I carry what's called a ferro rod as well. Okay? How many of you have seen a ferrocerium rod? All right? This thing is pretty cool.
Whoa, look at
some of that off there. I ain't going to throw sparks off of it all day long. But what are we lighting?
Dry leaves,
okay. That's a good way to think of it. Take it one step further. Anybody know what this is?
Pine straw.
Pine straw, right? Hay, you need the same thing.
Hay.
While pine straw is a good receptor for fire, there's one way to ensure that you get more fire. And that's actually taking doing what's called processing. So I take this, you can pick this up on the side of the road. You see it all blown off the side of it. It's called distressed pine straw. You can see a lot of little fibers in there.
Basically, right now,
little fibers in there. We're just going to take it, we're going to make some more fibers. Okay, we're taking just going to tear it up a little bit more.
Let's make it all feathery.
Because what happens with this is now, when we're ready to light it, either with a match, a lighter, or a ferro rod, or the sun, with a magnifying glass, or a bow drill, or the primitive drill. He's going to make it in a later class. Then we have ability and make sure that we get the fire lit. Now, this is just part one of a fire, right? You have to have small sticks, and when I say a bundle of small sticks, I'm talking a bundle of sticks that are smaller than a pencil. Okay? That's what I mean by small sticks. We take those sticks, we put them around.
The ferro rod. We need one of those. Whoa! Whoa! That, I turned my back and I was, whoa! Do it again. Isn't that amazing? He made fire with that.
So we can just do it one more time.
We were talking, matter of fact, you were talking about it last night. We had planned on doing it a while back, and never, because it's basically a case of
that one also.
There you go. Wow. We need a ferro rod.
If you do have something like pine straw or whatever, take and turn it over on itself because fire likes to climb. Right? There's a little trick for you, if you will. And in doing so, now we put our little twigs down, and we now have us a raging fire, and we're warm, and we have shelter, and we keep that plow point because it's a lot closer to the ground, and we don't have to have as much fire. Make sense?
Yeah.
Questions, comments, concerns?
Part of it. All right. An applause.
Thank you,
for the fire. Good job.
Hey, y'all, we got some more classes coming up. We've got
isn't that cool?
Local edibles. Miss Jennifer's going to be talking about those in a minute.
Local edibles.
Back on. We've got
is
the primitive
cool?
Fire drill.
Thank
we're
you.
We're going to hand drill.
Bye.
A bit. Bye. Thanks, Doc. So y'all stick around and see the rest of them, all right?